This is James Wright Foley.
The beheading of American journalist James Foley triggered a swift U.S. military response. Airstrikes aimed at Islamic State fighters in Iraq. But the practice of beheading is actually quite common in several countries, including one of the United States' closest allies, Saudi Arabia. This video of the beheading of a woman in Saudi Arabia was recently leaked online. It's too gruesome to show most of it, but it's prompting many to take a closer look at the country's system of law. Last year alone, 87 people were executed, most by public beheading, according to Human Rights Watch. Joe Stork heads up the Middle East division of that organization.
If you look at the ideology of ISIS, and if you look at the ideology of the, you know, ruling religious establishment in Saudi Arabia, there's not a whole lot of difference.
This crime and punishment chart shows ISIS and Saudi Arabia are almost identical. Stork says when it comes to Western leaders speaking out against these practices, they will only do so for certain countries.
When it comes to close allies, you know, all of a sudden there's a kind of a veil of silence.
So why the double standard? Well, many experts say the U.S. needs Saudi Arabia as a good friend, especially now with the growing instability in the region.
Saudi Arabia has been known to assist with intelligence gathering, military might, and of course, there's all that oil. That strong bond now made more clear in the wake of King Abdullah's death.
He was a very wise man, and he understood many things. He was very discreet in the way he was trying to engineer reforms.
King Abdullah had a long history of being a brave partner with us and with the world.
That partnership expected to continue unchanged in the months and years ahead. I'm Christine Frizzell reporting.